Hello everyone, this is InsaneJ, and today I am on our new Minecraft server. We're calling it HappyDiggers MC. And today I'm joined by Dom.
Hi guys.
And there's someone else here on the server with us. He's not in chat, but we'll just ignore him for now. Not because we're jerks, but because we are going to talk to you guys about this new server. I'm currently on the spawn world, at spawn to be precise. And this server is a server with a twist, I guess you could say. Because as soon as you start out on this server, we encourage you to get a jetpack. And you need the jetpack to gain access to areas outside of this immediate spawn area, which you see right here. And the way to do it is to pay attention to the NPCs. Hi Dom,
hi.
How are you doing? And read the signs. We have a bunch of rules. Basically it's very simple. If you respect other players and the stuff, you're okay. Mind your language and you should be fine. And well, in this area over here, you can see a few crafting recipes. There are airships and this is the crafting recipe for a coal jetpack. And there's wheat growing all over the place. NPC just told me. What's his name? Owen Maid? Who named this NPC?
Probably
anyway,
Pernix.
Probably Pernix, yeah. He's been awesome setting up all the NPCs around spawn. There's something you should know about the spawn world, and that is that wheat immediately replants itself. And that's important to know because with wheat, as you know, you can make bread. So let's continue to, where is it? The library. Because over here there is a librarian and he's going to sell us jetpack books and he sells them for one bread. So let's give him a bread. That gives me a book of jetpacks. And if you open the book of jetpacks, it will, well, basically explain how jetpacks work. I'm not going to read everything, just clicking through it. So, yeah, you need to get a book of jetpacks, and that will tell you to basically make, or how to make a jetpack. So we are going to follow this white carpet to get out of this building. And along the way you see more signs and more wheat, which you can get for free. So basically in this world and which world was it? Earthbound? That's not right. Just in this world, wheat grows back.
Yes, yes.
Just in this world. And here you see a bunch of players. They are a part of the VIP group. And here's Dom. Hi Dom.
Wait for it.
Wait for it.
Stand next to him.
That's the next. It's
dun,
Attack of
dun,
the Clown.
Dun.
We have
He's
two Doms.
He's looking at me. Anyways.
What are you looking at? What are you looking at? So, to the left is the wheat farm, and to the right is the mine. Do you have a jetpack? Talk to the traders. Just to be clear, talk to the traders. Because we are not going to explain everything to you. That's what all the NPCs are for.
Mm-hmm.
This is Cliffs. Hi, Cliffs. He's a new moderator. Oops. Hey, he has a headset. I didn't know he has a headset.
I didn't know that either. That's cool.
Nice. Anyway, virtual pack information. You have virtual chests and workbenches on the server, which you can purchase. So that's really nice. So you can basically get a jetpack, fly off, and have everything on you, I guess. Here's another trader. He also sells jetpacks. And jetpack books, I should say, and jetpacks. So, moving on. The mine is that way, and then down here. Here we have a hill, and in the hill is a mine. We call it the Underhill Mine.
Clever.
It's very clever. Okay, so the miner says, once you have your jetpack, you can travel to other islands or servers and mine better materials. So that's good to know. And Cole Smith can smelt ores. Well, basically he trades ores, but oh well. So we give him one bread and then we get a stone pickaxe. So that's fairly cheap. Free bread for one pickaxe. And then you get a bunch of iron. How much iron do we need?
Eight. If I remember correctly.
Okay.
Yes, well, eight.
I've got five.
And you need coal as well.
Coal as well. Okay, so let's get a bunch of stuff. Maybe you can use your admin powers and just give me the stuff I need. It would be probably be easier than
there
to
you go.
Mine everything. Where is it?
I don't know. I gave it to you with admin powers.
I've got nothing.
Oh, well.
So much for the admin powers. So I have 16 coal and 6 iron.
Oh,
seven.
Yeah. Oh, I gotta give you the 2 iron.
7 iron.
Mm.
Also, this server has...
there you go.
Thank you. The server has a lot of anti-cheat stuff enabled. All the block interactions and inventory interactions are logged. So that should keep people safe. Now, back to the trader. Let's get a bunch of iron. Then iron gives us iron chestplate. Iron chestplate and 8 coal gives us a jetpack.
Or you could craft it yourself.
Or you can craft it yourself. Right here, what a nice place to craft a jetpack. Hey, look at that sign! And that's Pernix. So, yeah, let's craft a jetpack. So that's... Wait for it. It's iron chestplate. And then you just put coal around it and you get a jetpack. So now I have 2 jetpacks. I already have 1 equipped. And it says fuel 0%. So what you do is you take coal in your hand and you right click just in the air. You don't have to click anything, just in the air, and then your jetpack will get fueled. So now it has 10% of fuel. And to fly, you just do as you do in creative mode, you double jump and off you go. That's it. Now I have a jetpack, and players are allowed to use jetpacks in this world. And in the Earthbound world and creative world, I think. So those are a bunch of worlds.
And the Nether as well, I think it works in.
Yeah, the Nether as well. So now you can actually go to this portal island over here at spawn. And as you can see, it just takes a few minutes to do this quest. But it should help us keep out players who are, well, let's just say, too impatient to have around. I think that's a nice way of putting it.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, on this portal island, you see Earthbound,
mm-hmm.
Which has a ton of shops, and it also has towny enabled. So you are allowed to start your own town in this world or on the Earthbound world. There's a creative world, which has plots, which you can claim, and then you can just build whatever you like on it. This one over here has a ton of signs on it. It's the small world. World? Yeah, that's not right. It's a small world. And it is whitelisted. If you want to join this world, you need to sign up on our forums. And this world will offer you a vanilla-like experience. So that means a lot of the essential stuff and the economy is disabled and a lot of the commands are disabled.
You also have a separate inventory in this world by comparison to the worlds such as Earthbound and the island world that we're currently in.
Yes, which is very important to know because, right now I have a ton of stuff in my inventory. And if we go to the small world real quick, you'll see my inventory right now is empty and it's raining because it's very sad. I can't take stuff with me to this world. So let's head back. And I leveled up. Nice.
Level 0.
Level 0. So yeah, that's the small world. It's a vanilla-like world. Keep it in mind, it's different from the other worlds. Then we have a nether, which is shared between this world and the earthbound world. And we have a skyblock world. Dom already made a video and I leveled up again. Nice. I'm level 20. this world also has a separate inventory. As you can see, I'm now level 20, and in the other world, I was level 0 and halfway to 1. Dom made a video on this world. I'll link it in the description. It's a lot of fun seeing him make obsidian instead of a cobble generator. No, wait, that was me. I'm joking. I'm just joking, guys. So yeah, there are a bunch of commands you need to know to use Island World. It's island, help, create, home, and spawn. So that should be pretty self-explanatory. I'm sure you guys figure it out. And leveled up again. That's a nice plugin. There's fireworks all over. So yeah, let's head to Earthbound.
Good idea.
And it's raining again. Can we turn off the rain for a bit? So depressing. So this is Medina Village. It's a server-owned town. I think I'm the mayor right now, but we'll probably set it to an NPC later on. There are a few plots for sale, so if you like, you can buy a plot here, but they are expensive because we would like to encourage players to, well, basically start their own towns. If I remember correctly, the towns do not require upkeep.
They do not.
So you have to pay to get a town, but after that, you don't have to pay a daily fee to keep it active. So you can play as much or as little as you like. You're not pressured to do anything here. Here we have the market area where you can, well, pretty much get anything in the game, even saplings, but the owner realized no one is actually going to buy saplings, so the
He
trader
left.
left. He left. He's gone. Here we have Bill and Ben. They are two brothers, and well, you know how brothers are. Mine's better though, Ben. Yes, Ben.
Bigger than Ben's flowers.
Oh yeah, and we have the block company clerks. They sort of clone their employees. And here we have food and seeds and mob drops. So yeah, basically anything you need you can buy or sell at this marketplace. And in this town, there are a few plots for sale, but you are encouraged to move out of town and start your own towns.
Or claim a town in the island world as well.
Yes, exactly. So the spawn world, this is a massive continent, basically, and it uses a custom world generator. So the landscape is more flat. No, flat isn't the right word. It's more gradual than regular Minecraft, which should make it easier to build stuff and to move around in it.
Also looks really pretty.
It also, yeah, it looks very nice. But the spawn world, I generated on my own PC, and it took about, I think, a month and a half to generate the entire world and stitch it together. It's pre-generated, but it's fairly large. I think it's 20,000 by 20,000 blocks or something. And it's well, let's just go back to the spawn area and take a look, because I can explain it, but it's probably better to take a look at it. And it turned night, so perhaps you would turn it into day. Thank you. And I think over here, this way, a few of our VIPs have already started the town. So I'm moving away from the spawn area. Let's check my jetpack. I still have 10% fuel, which is weird. I probably should have less by now.
Probably
Okay.
because you have admin powers.
It's probably because I have admin powers, yes. Regular players will consume fuel, so keep that in mind if you're flying around. If your fuel meter hits zero, you will crash. Yes, here we have a bunch of islands. As you can see, they are loading now. I do not have Optifine installed, so chunks are loading a bit slow for me. Over there is the spawn area, and over here is, well, someone started a nether-themed island, Mishrak. Don't know whose island this is.
I think it's Cliffs.
Cliffs, yeah. It does look like something Cliffs would build. He's always building nice stuff on our server. So yeah, we have pre-generated islands here, and these islands, they have all kinds of materials in them. On the underside here, you see some diamonds and coal and some other things are here as well. This is a dirt and stone island, but we also have islands made out of ice. And we have the mushroom biome islands, so there is a bunch of variety, and we have jungle islands and snow islands, and you can check them on Dyne Map. As you explore, you will see them appearing on Dyne Map. So yeah, I think that covers most of this server. No, we still have the creative world. Let's go there real quick. So I'm going back to spawn. Then to the spawn island, because here we go. It's called Creative. We're probably going to change the name to Plot Me, but for now it's Creative. This also has a separate inventory from the other worlds, and I'm in survival mode right now. It should be in creative mode, so
It'll
creative.
automatically set for normal players.
Yes. So if you join here, you will be in creative mode. And here you see a little bit of pixel art. It says Happy Diggers. There we go. It's loading. And over here we have a gallery of staff members and I think VIP members and old staff members. Here we have Damon. He's no longer staff. He's VIP now, but we put him in here anyway. And we have a bunch of other people flying in style, noob miner, and I think this is Cliffs? Who is this? It's KL. KL, sorry. KL, and then there's Code Cat. And this is new guy. Man, I'm terrible at names. Sorry. It's Rhodey.
That's not
Spurf.
new guy.
Yeah, he used to be new guy. Sorry. Okay, so Spurf, this handsome fellow, that's me. Then there's Dom. And
Yay.
then there's Wordy. And Pernix, and I think that's Marius. And then there's Eve,
Ethan, RJ,
RJ,
Brian, and
Ryan,
Mapia.
Mepia. So yeah, that's a gallery of staff members, VIPs, whatever, important people on the server. So if you see them, say hi, I guess. So yeah, in this creative world, you can claim plots. I think regular players can claim two plots or four plots. I don't
I'm not
remember.
sure. I think it's four.
Four, yeah.
Not sure.
So these square plots, they are 32 by 32 blocks, and you can pretty much build anything you like. I think you are allowed to build giant penises, so you don't have to ask. Just go ahead. If you want to build a penis, go nuts. Other than that, we are enforcing the respect other players and staff rules. Here are some commands how to use all this. It's at the spawn area when you enter this world, so you can look up the commands yourself. So penises are allowed, but stuff like swastikas aren't, and offensive language isn't allowed, and yeah, so use common sense. But we did allow the giant penises because everyone wants to build a giant penis for their first build, and we didn't want to ban people on their first build right away. So yeah, that's basically it. So this is Creative World. It's pretty empty right now. There are a few builds here and there, but
I use it as a test world.
yeah, exactly. It's just people trying stuff out, trying new designs. So this is your plot.
Yeah, this is going to be in my small world base.
Nice. Looks really nice. Staircase. Because Dom is on a small world. He's digging up a giant dome, I
I
think.
finished it the other day too.
You finished it? Wow. We
Like
should
just the
probably.
digging part.
Okay. We will show it in another video because this video is getting quite long as it is.
Can do.
So we're going to show you Dom's dome. And I think that's it. Did I miss anything? People need to know anything else? The server IP is mc.happydiggers.net.
And we're running 1.7.10.
Yes, very important to know because Minecraft just updated to 1.8 and we are on 1.7.10. So make sure you use that version to connect to the server. And oh yeah, the server is running on brand new hardware. So we have a second physical server now, just for this Minecraft server. It's hosted at first place, so he's generous enough to pay for the electricity. So yeah, I guess that's it. Thank you guys for watching, and we hope to see you on the server. Bye.
Bye.